Dear students, I, Mr. Vishal Shah, Assistant Professor, Krishna Institute of Pharmacy, Karad, once again welcome you all to this my YouTube channel. Today, we will be discussing yet another session of the Pharmaceutical Analysis 1 subject. Here, in this video, we are going to cover the preparation and standardization of different standard solutions. In previous video, we have covered with the primary standard and secondary standard. In that video, in detail, we have seen that what is the meaning of primary standard and the secondary standard. Now, as I told you that whenever we are going to prepare the solution of secondary standard, it is necessary to carry out the standardization of that solution. Means, it is not always possible to prepare the solution of exact theoretical concentration. So, it is necessary to check practically whether the solution that we have prepared is having the exact concentration. That's why standardization of secondary standard is necessary. So in this video, in detail, we will see the various examples of secondary standards which needs to be standardized and how to carry out the preparation of this standard solution. If you have not watched my previous videos, you can watch, and if you like the content of this my channel, then you can subscribe to my YouTube channel. So let's begin with our today's session. Before that, just we will see what are the learning outcomes of this session. After this session, students will be able to explain how to prepare and standardize different standard solutions. Okay. Now, before starting the particular session, just I will highlight on the points, what is the meaning of solution, what is the difference, or what is the meaning of the standard solution. Because if you see in that particular slide, previous slide also, I have written, we have to understand the standardization of the standard solution. Now, what is the meaning of standard solution? A solution of approximately desired molarity is prepared and standardized by titration against a solution of the primary standard. So, solution of accurately known strength, they are known as the standard solution. In previous video also, we have discussed what is the meaning of standard solution. If we prepare a solution of exact strength or the known strength, then that particular solution is known as the standard solution. But usually what happens when we are going to prepare the solution of the secondary standard, we are going to prepare it of approximately desired molarity. And this is first prepared and then standardized by titration against the solution of primary standard. As primary standards are nothing but the highly pure substances, if we weigh these particular substances, that is the primary standard, and if we prepare the solution of that particular primary standard, then it is possible to know the strength of that particular primary standard solution. So, by preparing the known strength of that primary standard, we are going to determine the molarity of the secondary standard. As strength of standard solution may change upon standing, the molarity factor should be redetermined frequently. Means, suppose I prepare a solution today at 10 in morning, and if I want to use that particular solution in afternoon, at morning also I have to carry out the standardization, and in afternoon also I have to carry out the standardization. Because if we keep standard solution as such, the strength of that particular standard solution may change upon standing. Volumetric solutions should not differ from the prescribed strength by greater than 10%. And molarity should be determined with the precision of 0.2%. Means here, if I prepare 1 molar in AOH, then if I carry out the standardization of that NaOH, the variation in that particular two strengths should not be more than 10%. So now, first we will see the preparation of oxalic acid, that is 0.1 normal. So here we will discuss in detail how to prepare the 0.1 molar, sorry, normal solution of oxalic acid, and again how to carry out the standardization of this particular oxalic acid. The molecular formula of the oxalic acid is H2C2O4. Now, why I am giving molecular formula over here? Because when we are going to carry out the preparation of normal or molar solution, then we will require how much moles of that particular primary standard as well as the secondary standard, they are consumed in that particular reaction. And depending upon that, we are going to calculate the factor. So, from molecular formula, we can calculate the molecular weight. So, molecular weight of the oxalic acid is 90.03. Now, how to carry out the preparation of the oxalic acid? We have to dissolve, if we want to prepare 0.1 normal oxalic acid, we have to dissolve 6.3 gram of oxalic acid in sufficient water to produce the 1000 ml. So that if we take 6.3 gram of oxalic acid, then it will correspond to the 0.1 normal solution of oxalic acid. Always we have to prepare the volumetric solution into the volumetric flask. So first we have to take sufficient quantity of water. In that we have to add 6.3 gram of oxalic acid, and we have to carry out the addition of sufficient water to produce the 1000 ml of that particular solution. So this is the way by which we can prepare the 0.1 normal solution of the oxalic acid. Now after that we will see how to carry out the standardization. Now for the purpose of standardization, we have to pipette out 25 ml of 0.1 molar NaOH, which needs to be first standardized because it is a secondary standard, and transfer it to the clean conical flask. To it, we have to add 2 to 3 drops of phenolphthalein indicator, and we have to titrate it against 0.1 normal oxalic acid solution until color changes from purple to colorless. Normally, as this oxalic acid is a primary standard, it is not necessary to carry out the standardization of this oxalic acid. But still, I am giving you here procedure so that you should understand how to carry out the standardization of different standard solutions. With the help of diagrammatic representation, also I will show you how to carry out the standard of oxalic acid. So here, for that purpose, I have kept few glassware. This is known as the volumetric flask. Here you can see one mark. So when I put a solvent up to this mark, then it corresponds to the 1000 ml of the total solution, depending upon this volume of this particular volumetric flask. These volumetric flasks are available in several ranges, from 10 ml to 100, then 1000, 2000 ml, that much quantity. So we have taken, you can assume that we have taken 1000 ml volumetric flask. This is your beaker. This is the bottle which is consisting of oxalic acid. As we have said, in the preparation of oxalic acid solution, we have to take 6.3 gram of the oxalic acid to 1000 ml to produce the 0.1 normal solution. So here you can see we are taking the bottle of oxalic acid, we are removing the cap. With the help of the spatula, we are taking exact quantity, that is equivalent to 6.3. With the help of the balance, we are going to wet that quantity and we are going to transfer it into our volumetric flask, in which already we have taken some amount of water. Once we have dissolved that oxalic acid, then with the help of the beaker, we are going to make up the volume up to 1000 ml. And once we have make up the volume to the 1000 ml, this preparation of oxalic acid is completed. Then next part, we have to carry out the standardization of oxalic acid. So for that purpose, as we have seen in the procedure, we have to take the 25 ml of 0.1 normal NaOH. Also, we have to add the phenolphthalein indicator. So here, this is your pipette with the help of the bulb. Then this is your conical flask in which we are going to carry out the addition of our titrate. Here, we are taking 0.1 normal NaOH. With the help of the pipette, we are going to pipette out the 0.1 normal NaOH, 25 ml of NaOH is required, which is to be added to our conical flask. After that, we are going to take the phenolphthalein. Few drops of phenolphthalein needs to be added as a indicator. So here we are taking that phenolphthalein solution, and just we are going to carry out the addition of that phenolphthalein indicator. As soon as we add the phenolphthalein solution as indicator, the color of that particular solution becomes pink to purple. When base is present, and if we add the phenolphthalein as indicator, then that leads into the change of the color to the pink or purple. After that, we require a burette in which, suppose we have placed the oxalic acid. Here you can see we have filled the oxalic acid up to the zero mark. Slowly we are going to carry out the addition of this oxalic acid into this particular conical flask. Now there will be the reaction between the oxalic acid and the NaOH that we have added, that is the neutralization type of reaction takes place, and at the end of our reaction, when whatever the amount of NaOH that we have added, once it is to be reacted, then as soon as we add the extra amount of oxalic acid, as the base is not present in our conical flask, due to that extra presence of oxalic acid, color it changes from pink to the purple. So here you can see that we have added some amount of water, so reaction will take place. Again we have continued the addition of that particular water. As soon as it reach to the end point, that leads into the disappearance of the color. So in this way we are going to carry out the calculation of standardization of oxalic acid, and with the help of the formulas we are going to calculate the exact strength of that particular oxalic acid. So for that purpose we are going to use this particular reaction. Here you can see 1 mole of oxalic acid is consumed with the 2 moles of NaOH. So I will show you how to carry out the factor calculation. Here in this case you can see 1 mole of oxalic acid is equivalent to 2 moles of sodium hydroxide, because here 2 moles of NaOH are consumed. Now if we convert, or if we take 1000 ml of 1 molar oxalic acid, that is equivalent to 80 grams of NaOH, because 1 mole of sodium hydroxide is nothing but the 40 grams of NaOH. If we take 1000 ml of 1 normal, this oxalic acid, that is equal to 40 grams of NaOH. Because here you can see 1 mole of the oxalic acid is equal to 0.5 normal oxalic acid. So if we divide it by the 1000, so 1 ml of 0.1 normal oxalic acid is equivalent to 0.0040 gram of NaOH. So in this way we are going to use this particular factor. In practicals, in detail, we will see how to calculate the factor. So this is about the preparation and standardization of oxalic acid. Also, in this video we will see how to carry out the preparation and standardization of sodium hydroxide. The molecular formula, same procedure is utilized. Again, molecular formula of NaOH is 40. Now for preparation of 1 molar NaOH, we have to take 1 mole of NaOH, that is nothing but the 40 grams of sodium hydroxide, which is dissolved in sufficient carbon dioxide free water. Carbon dioxide free water means what? We have to carry out the boiling of that particular solution water, and we have to cool that, so that whatever the carbon dioxide that is dissolved, it will be evolved. Then how to carry out the standardization? Weight accurately 5 gram of potassium hydrogen phthalate, which is nothing but the primary standard, previously powdered and dried at 120 degrees Celsius for 2 hours, and we have to dissolve it into 75 ml of carbon dioxide free water. Add 0.1 ml of phenolphthalein and titrate against the sodium hydroxide solution until permanent pink color is produced. Here the reaction utilized is potassium hydrogen phthalate and NaOH. So 1 mole of potassium hydrogen phthalate is required and 1 mole of NaOH. So here 1 mole of NaOH is equivalent to 1 mole of potassium hydrogen phthalate. So similarly we can calculate the factor, that 1000 ml of 1 molar NaOH is equal to 204, that is the molecular weight of this potassium hydrogen phthalate. By dividing by 1000, we will get 1 ml of 0.1 normal NaOH is equivalent to 0.2042 gram of C8H5KO4. So in this way we can prepare
different standardized solution. In next video also we will see different other solutions. Thank you.